Hello students, good morning. Today we will discuss the chapter 2nd, large numbers, standard 4. This is part 7 of this chapter. Okay, we will discuss subtraction of numbers. You see, the process of subtraction of large numbers is almost same as that of subtraction of small numbers. That means the number subtraction of small numbers are also same like subtraction of large numbers. You see the example, subtraction without borrowing. Without borrowing, the example is given. Subtract 347215 from 569958. We have to subtract 347215 from the number 569958. First, before subtraction, first you know that the number from which another number is to be subtracted is called the minuend. What is minuend? The number from which another number is to be subtracted. Here the minuend is 3, 4. Okay, you see, the number from which another number is subtracted is called minuend. So the minuend is 569958. Why? Because we are subtracting 347215 from 569958. So this is minuend. And another is subtrahend. Subtrahend means the number which is to be subtracted is called subtrahend. Here the subtrahend is 347215. Okay, first we will write the minuend number, then subtrahend number, then put a minus number, minus mark. You see the given example, then we will subtract from one's line, from one's column. 8 minus 5, 3, 10's column, 5 minus 1, 4, 100's column, 9 minus 2 equal to 7, 1000's column, 9 minus 7 equal to 2, 10,000's column, 6 minus 4 equal to 2, in lakhs column, 5 minus 3 equal to 2. So the answer is 2,22,743. Okay, did you understand? Then subtraction with borrowing. With borrowing, when the numbers of minuend is small and the numbers of subtrahend is large, we have to borrow from the next column. You see the example, find the difference of 486740 and 849604. This is the largest number, 849604. So we subtract 486740 from 849604. Here the minuend is 849604 and the subtrahend is 486740. Then write the numbers according to their place value. See in the example, in ones place 40, so we can subtract easily, but in tens place the minuend number is 0 and subtrahend number is 4, it is impossible to subtract 0, 4 from 0. So, we borrow 100. Here in 100 plus 6, we borrow 1 and it will become 10. When we will borrow 100, 2 tens plus 10 tens equal to 100. So, it will become 10. Then you see the hundreds plus, when 1 is borrowed, the rest is 5. We can't subtract 5, 7 from 5. So, we will borrow 1 from thousands plus, here is 5, a thousand, 1000, that is 1500. When 1 comes from the largest column to the lowest column, it will become 10. Before it was 5, 5, 10, 15, so it became 15. Then here after borrowing 1, it is 9, 9 minus 6, 9 minus 1, 8, 8 minus 6 is 2, so we can easily, we don't have to borrow. In 10,000's place, we have to borrow from 1 from lakhs place. So, it is 14. You see here. Now, we will subtract. From in 1's place, 4 minus 0 equal to 4. In 10's place, after borrowing, the number is 10 minus 4 is 6. In 100's place, 15 minus 7 equal to 8. In 1000's plus 8 minus 6 is 2. In 10,000 plus 14 minus 8 is 6. In lakhs plus 7 minus 4 equal to 3. So the answer is 362864. That is 362,864. Okay. Now we subtract 31397 from 73913 and check the difference. First we subtract, after subtracting we check whether the answer is correct or not. First arrange the minuend and subtrahend according to the place value. We see after writing the numbers, then subtract. In 1's plus 3 minus 7, it is not possible. So, borrow 1 from 10's plus, that is 13 minus 7 is 6. Then go to 10's plus, here there is 1, after borrowing, it is 0. Then borrow 1 from 100's plus, that is 10. 10 minus 9 equal to 1. In 100's place, before it was 9, after taking 1 to 10's place, here is 8. 8 minus 3 equal to 5. Then 1000's place, 3 minus 1, 2. In 10,000's place, 7 minus 3 equal to 4. So, the answer is 42,516. After subtraction, when we will check whether the answer is correct or wrong, first we will add the subtrahend to the answer. If the answer is minuend, then it is correct. That means we have to add the answer with the subtrahend. You see the example here is written 42516, which is the answer. Then write the subtrahend 31397. Then we add. The answer is 73913, which is equal to minuend. So it is checked, which is same as minuend, sorry, not subtrahend, it is equal to minuend. So, it is correct. Okay, it is also checked. Now there are some more subtraction given. You do the problems as homework. Tomorrow we see these answers. Okay. Now we will discuss finding a missing addend. The missing addend can be found by subtracting the given addend from the sum. When if we have to find out the missing addend, we have to subtract the given addend from the sum. You see the question, the sum of the two numbers is 35,471. This is the sum, and the one of the number is 20,497. This is one of the given addend. We have to find the other. Okay, first two, you see 20,497 plus another addend, we don't know. The sum is 35,471. So, to get the missing addend, we have to subtract the given addend from the sum. That is 35,471 minus the given addend is 20,497. So the answer is 14,974. So the next addend is 14,974. When we have to, you see, the subtraction is done here in the right side. Okay. Next, we will do the word problems in the next part. Now we will do finding the missing minuend or subtrahend. Now we will discuss about how to find minuend, missing minuend or missing subtrahend. To find the missing minuend, the subtrahend is added to the difference. To find missing minuend, the subtrahend is added to the difference. Suppose you see the example, the what number should be subtracted from 26,461, what number should be subtracted from 26,461 to get to 24,378. So, to get means this is the answer, and subtracted from 26,461, subtracted from 26,461 means this is the, what is this? Minuend. We know the subtrahend. So we have to, what have to do? We have to add subtrahend with the answer. You see the example, the answer is 24,378 and subtrahend is 26,461. So the addition sum is 50,839. So this is the answer. We have to, this is the minuend. From this, when we will subtract 26,461, we get 24,378. Okay. You see the next example here, we have to find the mixing subtrahend. That means the minuend is given and the difference is also given. We have to find out the subtrahend. You see the example, the minuend is 87,653. The difference is 23,458. We have to find out the missing subtrahend. To missing subtrahend, to get the missing subtrahend, we have to subtract the difference from the minuend. You see the next answer. This is the minuend. We have to subtrahend. The answer is 64,195. So when we subtract 64,195 from 87,653, the answer is we will get 23,458. Okay, this is the difference we will get. Okay, thank you. Next, we do all the word problems of addition and subtraction. Okay.